I'm meant to be. I will not die before I'm dead. I know I'm meant to be. I will not be stopped by what they say. I know I'm meant to be. I will not die before I'm dead. What is good, savages? What is good? All right, so today we're filming a special video for a big star. Actually, he's a comedian in France, and he's here in Togo. So he decided to do like a collaboration with Adebayor. So he played like a small football match. And yeah, thanks to Julio, I'm here and I'm filming for them, you know? So it's gonna be interesting. I'm gonna do a montage. You guys can see it. Boom.
Go so good to me, I got them for so good to baby. Your body, roboto make up and I'm like a go so make up like you go up to Ojibo make with you go to.
Yeah, and bed, kilo day, and bed. Yeah, and bed, double X, a long bay. One berry, berry for me, one berry. Oti pe toju mi tin leri oti pe 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 ju lagberi ojo koto no se mi a tu like popo when you find go so koto oh shawale da it's your body dey ro koto make us spin am like koko so make up like you go up koto shawale da
And yeah, as you guys can see, they have a really big crowd. Like, this guy has 4.5 million followers on Facebook and almost 1 million on Instagram. Like, the guy is actually well known. He's a cool guy. He's a cool guy. Great atmosphere, him and Adebayor. So later on, we're gonna film another video of them like having dinner, chilling out. So yeah, it's gonna be cool. All right, see you there. As you can see, man, these guys are really popular. It's cool. It's really nice to see like fans. It's really nice to have fans like that. Savage crew one day will be like this.
It's not Adebayor who do this to me.
I actually feel bad for you, my man.
Bro, it's the defender.
Yeah. Alright guys, so this is the apartment these guys are staying in. Like, it's a really cool place.
This English is too hot for me. I just try.
You're trying, bro. That's it. I understand you. It's cool.
I turn the light. So, I'm the only one who play.
Yeah. And the only one who got injured.
Yes. And I got the injury. you like my play?
I mean, yeah, it was good. I got some good shots from you. I got some good scenes.
Nope.
But my comment is that
your teammates.
My teammates.
Yeah.
Don't like me. They don't pass me the ball because they don't know me.
That's true. Missing chemistry.
Yes. Any chemistry. In the team.
Okay.
Adebayor is too strong.
Yeah. And he blows.
Oh God.
If he blows the game, Adebayor, it's 10-0.
I swear.
He blows the game,
10-0. Yo, I'm gonna show footage that he was attacking one guy, man.
Yes,
the guy was scared. He let the ball go just like that. Yo, no lie, the vibe over here is very nice. I like these guys, they're really cool. Like, first time we meet, but it's really awesome. You can tell these guys are genuine. So, for real, this is gonna be an epic vlog. Alright, let's make it fun.
Yeah.
Alright guys, so as you can see, these are funny ass videos, so you guys should definitely support this guy. Like, Axel Merryl, I'll show you the name and you can just check it out for yourselves. He does French comedy, but he also translates to English, which is pretty good. And now I'm having a blast just looking at them. Like, I'm watching some of them for the first time right now, and super interesting, no doubt about it. People, the PS5 is actually here. I've never seen a PS5 yet. I want to see the graphics.
People, check it out. We're actually now in the house of Adebayor. This place is humongous. Absolutely humongous. It is nothing I expected it to be. And now I'm just filming the behind the scenes so these guys can have a memory of doing this. And I appreciate Julio because he got me onto this and everything is cool. Yeah, so we're about to film it up. And
it's gonna be crazy.
Guys, goddamn. Like, I have to get a video with Adebayor. I have to.
So yeah, people, I was actually there to film the behind the scenes for Axel, right? So nothing more, nothing less. And then all of a sudden he tells, yeah, we need actors. So he tells me, hop in on the video. I'm like, hop in the video with him and Adebayor. I'm like, why not? Sure, why not? Now the video came out nice. You guys can check it out. I'll post the link down below so you can just see it. I write comedy sketch with Adebayor, and you guys can just click on the link to go and watch it after the video because we need views. But no, guys, without a shadow of a doubt, Adebayor is actually a very, very cool guy, you know? He's a free-spirited dude. Like, I did not even expect him to be this cool, you know? Like, I really don't know what to expect of people, and especially, like, with the celebrities and everything. So that's why I don't really mind. I don't really dabble into trying to figure them out, you know? But when I met him, and I was like, nah, this guy is humble. This guy is cool. It's understandable if he has to keep his distance from people because sometimes, like, some people can get annoying in this country, you know? Like, they just, like, get into your business too much, you know? And, yeah. Apart from that, he's a great dude, and I really, really hope that I get the chance to actually do a vlog with him. I do want to. I want to have, like, a full day with spending a full day with Adebayor, you know? It'll be great. It'll be super awesome. He has some interesting things in this country, and honestly, like, I'm sure people would love to know what his house looks like, you know, his day-to-day routine. I have a lot of fans that watch football here, so they'll definitely be interested to know what's up, you know. And I saw the reaction on my Instagram when I posted a small highlight for the Adebayor trailer that I have coming up. So I'm sure people would like this, and maybe it might kick off my career on YouTube here in Africa, because honestly, oh boy, we about to get into that nitty-gritty stuff. People in Africa do not give a fuck about vlogging. To be quite honest, I understand them, but at the same time, it's kind of discouraging, because, like, this goes back to this African mentality thing that people don't like to uplift others, really. They like to sabotage or try to say, like, oh, this guy's coming to take my place. So they try to, they get mad for some reason. Now, I'm not going to talk for myself as an example, and I don't want to use any of it as an example because I really don't care. The thing is that, like, I'm doing me. I am myself. You cannot replicate me. I'm doing something different from others, and there's no point in trying to, like, get mad at me because, like, I'm doing me, you know? Like, you cannot replicate me anyways. There's no point in replicating. As you can see, I am struggling to be me. So why the hell are you coming to try to take me down even more? You know what I mean? I'm like, yo, dude, for real, focus on what you want to focus on. I don't like this, dude. Like, imagine every time I come to my country, it's like, yo, you're not Africa. You don't think like Africans. You don't have an African mentality. I'm like, so having an African mentality is not a negative thing? I'm like, I was raised by two African parents all my life. It's just that I was born in Lebanon. I grew up there and I did everything there. Doesn't make me Lebanese, like, you know? Like, I can think like them, but I am not like them, and I don't do anything like them. I don't do anything like Africans. I don't do anything like Americans. I am just myself. I just grew up with people that are, like, from Africa, and I grew up with people that are from Lebanon. It doesn't mean I have the mentality of any of them. I just pick up the best sides of each, and I just move on with my life. That's how it's supposed to be. Pick out the things from all the cultures and just move on with your life. But that's not the point here. The point here now is that I am in Africa, and this African mentality thing, unfortunately, is really proving to me to be true. No matter how much I tell myself, like, nah, I'm not gonna judge everything because everybody's different. But I'm sorry, but majority of the people are like this. They like to sabotage other people or talk behind other people's back so they can take down their business and then take their place. Like, it's true. Like, my guys, like, for me, I do not give a fuck if I get the job, do not get the job. Like, if I get it, it's because, okay, like, yeah, I was there at the right time. It was the opportunity for me, goods for me. Like, it's good. It's good for me, you know? If I don't get it, no, I move on. I try to find something else. You know, like, I really don't take my time and try to, like, go bring someone down so I can go back up. They're really, 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 for me, like, I know there's other nationalities that do the same thing, you know? It's not, like, an exception. But, like, the problem is people that are already down and they're trying to go on the rise, they literally shift their whole career, the whole trajectory of what they're doing, even if they're doing something amazing, and they try to bring someone down so they can try to take the other guy's place while they're doing something completely different, right? That's why I'm like, dude, why do you care about the other person? Do your thing. You're doing something good. Then focus on that thing. Focus on that thing. You have a certain passion. Everybody has a certain passion. I have a certain thing I can do. I don't try to go into a different area thinking like, yeah, I can do this too. You know, like, no. I'm just doing what I love, you know? And what I love, I eventually do better because, like, I know what I'm doing, you know? I'm trying to learn as fast as I can and learning from all my mistakes every single time. Like, YouTube is one of my things. I love to do it. And I don't see anybody doing it over here, you know? But if somebody does it, I'm not going to discourage them. Of course not. Because I'm going to kick them off because they're doing something else. You cannot be me. You cannot replicate me. So I don't care. So, if anything, I'll just tell you, hey, guys, support this guy. If you like his content, go check him out, man. That's it. And you guys see me, I've been supporting people. Like, I have a playlist just for my friends or people that I find talented. And I'm like, you know, go ahead, do your thing. But at the end of the day, guys, I'm talking from my perspective, okay? There's no scientific evidence behind all this shit that African mentality is actually a thing. But unfortunately, I do see it. I do witness it a lot. And that's why, like, it's bothering me. And this is the reason why Africans are not succeeding the way they should. Because, like, honestly, just self-sabotaging each other, honestly, that's the truth. But instead of focusing on what did the white man do, try to focus on what can you do, right? I think that's the best way to think about it. And how about we support each other, you know? Like, as when I came back here, because I'm used to Lebanon, I was trying every single product that's from Lebanon. But then I started shifting because, like, you know, my mom was raised in Togo, you know. My dad's from Burkina Faso, I'm like, and they lived a healthy life, and they're probably healthier than most people from other countries and everything. So I'm like, let me start dabbling into eating the same food, testing the same products, you know, supporting local things, you know. Some things are just not good, but some things are good, you know. And I'm like, I will recognize them, and I'll shout them out, and I'll give them credit when it's due, you know. So that's what we have to do. We have to support each other, support brands that we have here, and support each other in our dreams. Because honestly, if one person wins, the other team people can win, you know? Because, like, if you open up a door for one African, that opens up a door for 10 more Africans. Because think about it this way. Okay, I'm a YouTuber. Eventually, if I succeed, I'll need a team. I'll need a videographer. I'll need maybe a guy who can manage my deals with brands and all that shit. I'll need somebody that can maybe manage my clothing, manage anything, you know? Maybe transportation or somebody that can manage logistics. That's already a team. Imagine, like, I succeed, now I have 10 other people. Now they're under me and they're working. It doesn't have to be that they're under me, you know, but they're working with me to make me grow even more and make Africa, boom, on the map. It gets more people from outside. They come to Africa. They invest in the country. The country keeps blowing up. Simple as that. But as well, the government does not help Africans. Yo, for real, please, government. Calm down on people, like, for real. People are just trying to, like, invest in the country, trying to benefit Africa. Yes, there are benefits for them because, like, at the end of the day, if you don't help yourself, you cannot help others. Simple, you know? But they are really, like, squeezing the hell out of the youth because, honestly, even I had ideas and everything. But then when I came back here and I'm like, they were making me go left and right, just to get through small things, procedures, so I can open up a small business. And I'm like, yo, I can't do this, bro. Like, I wasted most of my money just trying to, like, get through from this person to person B to person C to person D, and then I got no result. It also happened with my guys, you know, my friends and everything. I witnessed it. So there's a lot of factors that come to play when it comes to this African mentality thing. But at the end of the day, let's do something for ourselves. And honestly, right now, the best way I see fit is social media, because there's no way that anybody can control you. Social media, it's your opinion, your platform, your everything. I time to wrap it up, guys. It was a pleasure for this video. Next week is gonna be more interesting. So I'm hoping that I'll get a chance to actually do a whole vlog with Adebayor. It's gonna be awesome. See you guys next week, next Tuesday.